Hi everyone. So I'm just going to present you our strategy for the coronavirus pandemic, how Pragmatic is dealing with it. The idea is to showcase some of the things which we are doing to make sure that the level of service what we provide is not affected. We do our best in terms of serving our customers, as well as making sure that we are dealing with the situation in an effective manner to come out of this pandemic healthy, as well as making sure that we are not impacting any of our customer delivery. So I would say, I know it is difficult to believe, but we are really in a recession, worse than 2008. Although we've already seen the initial turbulent times with the stock markets crashing all over the world, and we are the initial days where we are starting to see the effects of how this virus situation is going to impact all of us. I strongly believe that we need to be really careful and cognizant of the situation and make sure we are taking preemptive measures to make sure none of our business gets impacted. Although it will impact, but how do we come out as safe as possible and through this particular situation? I'm putting here forward some of the facts and figures about coronavirus. So there are about 5 million plus cases worldwide. There has been already 220,000 people died because of coronavirus, and most of the deaths are from developed countries, including United States. Also, India has been impacted in this, but comparatively less number of cases here, and it is said that by end of May, we're gonna have reduction in our cases here. But I think we'll still continue with the cases throughout this particular year. The world economy has contracted by about 3% this year, and India, which is generally grows at 5 or 6%, will be only growing at 1.9%. So there's about 4% reduction in our GDP and projected growth, which is a big concern. So in order to deal with the situation when the lockdown happened in March, we put forward three particular goals: that we are not going to fire any employee, we are not going to reduce any salaries or incentives of any individuals. At the same time, we're going to make sure that the company stays in green. How do we contrast this with other companies? There will be many companies who have actually fired a lot of people. There are estimated 50 million people or employees have been fired since the coronavirus, and probably even more. There are companies who have cut down the salaries of employees by 50%. Appraisals has been cancelled for this year as well as many years, and a lot of things have happened in the last few weeks and months. We as a company, I think we wanted to make sure that we take certain preemptive measures and steps to make sure that we sail through this. We, for the month of April, we took some actions. We made Saturday working, which I think turned out to be really a boon. We also made sure that salaries are not sent in one shot. We've actually made our salaries in phases to make sure that we safeguard against any cash flows issues of customers not paying us. We are supporting even those employees who are unable to work or contribute because of this particular situation. Also, we did very close project and employee productivity monitoring to make sure that we stay efficient. Here are some of the achievements which we had in the month of April. We actually launched about 6 new apps on the Odoo App Store, which includes the Zoom Connector app. Also, we achieved our target of billable hours for the month of April, and we had new customer adds as well as we have new employees added to our team. Here is a graph of our people on bench versus people who have been put on projects. So about 62% of our employees in the month of March were on live projects, and about rest of the people were on support or app store work. If you see this graph, this includes all the data, which does not include Saturday working. So we had about 67% employees. So we did much better in the month of April in spite of the lockdown in terms of people utilization on live projects. When you look at including Saturdays, I think we had about 66% utilization of our resources on Saturdays. And then if you see only Saturdays, so employees when they worked on Saturdays, we achieved about 66% productivity, which is, I think, is a good achievement. because working on Saturday, people would generally think we'll get lower productivity, but I think we ended up having pretty good productivity on Saturdays as well. So how did we achieve this? Of course, this is a teamwork. We had a great team together working on projects. We have project leads who made sure that we are getting continuous work from our customers. They worked really hard on that. Our HR team and other teams worked to make sure that we are productive by monitoring timesheets and monitoring the productivity of the employees. There were resistance from a very small section of employees to work on Saturdays, but I think they eventually realized that it was really important, and they also got on board and really worked hard to make sure that we get better productivities on Saturday as well. Challenges faced by us while working from home. This probably looks almost similar to most of the companies. Of course, team coordination is a big issue when you work with large teams on different projects, and when your teams are spread across in multiple countries and multiple time zones. We face the same issues. Infrastructure issues like internet issues also play in quite a lot. Already, we had some customers and projects which were delayed or pushed back for later time of the year, mainly because of the currency, because of the virus situation. But still, in spite of that, we had new customer adds, as well as we got more work from existing customers to make sure that we are hitting our target of billable hours. Also, project management becomes a challenge because of the distributed team, distributed customers, and complex teamwork. So what's in future? We have appraisals lined up in 2020. The lockdown might continue until July. Also, there would be a challenge in terms of getting employees back to work once the virus situation opens up. Also, there's not been much help from the government in supporting small, medium-sized businesses, so we really left with ourselves to support. So we thought that we got to stand for ourselves and really work hard and make sure that we are aligning to the expectations of the customers. So does the standard HR policies really work? I beg to differ. I think things are very different now than what it used to be before. So we cannot have the same HR policies. So I think internally we thought through and we thought what are the things which are really important to make sure that we are not going to a stage where we continue with the same HR policies which are going to bite us in the future. So we made some amendments to our HR policies temporarily till the lockdown gets over to make sure that all the challenges faced are taken care and we are having the same level of productivity or even better when we used to work from office. So some of the changes which we are contemplating or we have applied already is Saturday working and alternate Saturday working. Also, we are thinking about and implementing public holiday working, which I think becomes important in cases where we want better productivity, also better support to our customers. And these are some of the HR policy changes which we have done temporarily until the lockdown gets over. And really in the hope that we are going to be seeing through this storm strongly. All this is possible because of the support from our pragmatic family, all these people you see on the screen. Been really working day and night to make sure that we are delivering our projects on time. We are working very hard. We do our best to sail through this particular situation. And we really are making sure that all the entire teamwork is really working hard, the leads, as well as developers, as well as business analysts, designers, salespeople, admin, accounting people, to so that we can sail through this. So I really would like to thank the Pragmatic team for all the efforts they put in April, and I'm really hoping that they continue to do so in May and more months to come. I would just leave out with this particular thought that tough times don't last, but tough teams do. And I'm really proud and confident that Pragmatic team is really a tough team, and we'll sail through this storm, and we'll do our best, whatever is required, to make sure we are delivering our work on time and on budget. We are supporting our customers, and we are all very much dedicated to this. Thanks all for listening in.